Hey, Blues fans, this is Anthony from Texas Blues Alley coming to you from underneath about a foot of snow up here in the Northeast. I've been fighting a pretty nasty sinus infection for the past couple of weeks, so I've been kind of MIA. Tried to go to the NAMM show. Big mistake. Airplane pretty much demolished me, and I'm hoping my voice doesn't sound as bad to you as it does in my head right now. So given how much I had to do today fighting the elements, I don't have a whole lot of time for a lesson. So what I'm going to do is teach three very simple things that you can start using immediately when you do this little slide from box two to box one. That's a slide that we've all done before, and I have three little tips for how you can play that, that kind of dress it up a little bit from the most obvious way that we usually play it. There's no tabs necessary for this lesson. It's probably usable by just about anybody of any skill level. I hope you enjoy it. All right, so for most of these, I'm going to be demonstrating in the open key here. I'm in standard tuning, so that puts us in the key of E. So the slide that I'm talking about is, you know, you got your box one shape. That little slide right there is something that we've all played in various songs, but then there's something that usually follows it, which is a slide back down along the G string into box one. You can hear this at the beginning of Pride and Joy. So that's the slide that I'm talking about, and what I want to show you is three very simple ways that you can give that a little bit more spice beyond just... The default way is just sliding from 4 to 2, then open, then down to 2 on the D string. First way is to slide to 2, then hammer on from open to 1 on the G string, and then down to 2 on the D string. What that does is it gives us the major kind of sugar, the major chord there, that's the major third of the scale. That won't sound right in every song, obviously, but if it's a song that has room for a little bit of a major flare, it sounds just a little bit sweeter than... Okay. Second way is to do a little double track, backtrack here. So instead of the slide from 4 to 2, we're just going to drop to 2, slide up to 3, and back again. It creates a little bit of fast movement in the middle of a otherwise predictable kind of sequence. So that's the first way. We'll hammer on there to the major third. Second way, drop to 2. Up to 3 and back again. Last way, one of my favorites. This one's a little bit more subtle. I'm going to do a little reverse rake before you start your slide down here. You want to keep the E string ringing. You want to keep the B string ringing out. And the G string. And then... I slow it down, I'm going to reverse, except that it all kind of gets mushed together and muted a little bit. So let me put it in context here. That little reverse rake with the little clicks and the creates kind of a gulping sound is one of those nice little style things that Stevie Ray Vaughan used to do in his playing, and he really draws this out sometimes, and sometimes you hear it and it doesn't register that he's doing something different than just, but that little gulping reverse rake there makes a big difference. So there you have it, three very simple little tips for how to take that slide from box two to box one and dress it up a little bit. If you're new to Texas Blues Alley, you can find all of these free Lesson Friday videos over at this site at texasbluesalley.com. Look for this section called The Woodshed. That's where all of our courses and free lessons are, and free Lesson Fridays inside of there. And if you want to, you can sign up for a 30-day free trial of our TXBA Locals membership program, where you get access to all the courses that I've put out over 10 years and some great learning tools in our pro player. You can find more information about that at texasbluesalley.com/locals. Until next time, thanks for watching.